Hello, and welcome to Resurgam's video on friction stir welding testing, following our previous one on the same topic. Enjoy! The TUDelft University of Technology investigates fatigue phenomena of friction stir welded joints. Fatigue phenomena are about crack development for cyclic loading and response conditions in materials and structures, which is about turning an intact geometry into a cracked one. Welded joints are particularly sensitive to fatigue because of defects at materials level or notches at structures level. The TUDelft University of Technology develops fatigue damage criteria, in particular for welded joints. Fatigue damage criteria developed over time are classified with respect to type of information, geometry, parameter, and process zone, including plane and live region limitations. At the moment, a fatigue damage criterion is being developed for friction stir welded joints and steel structures. In the Resurgam project, several challenges have to be faced. With respect to fatigue, it is about incorporating the welding parameter-dependent material microstructure as well as defect size. At structures level, it is about the surface roughness as well as the undercut. Fatigue tests are performed to assess the fatigue performance of friction stir welded joints. The Welding Institute provides the friction stir welded joints, which are then cut into dog bone shaped specimens. The dog bone shaped specimens are mounted into the testing rig. A program is created that specifies the amount of load that is applied on the specimen. The load is applied in a cyclic manner, meaning that the force increases and decreases repeatedly in time. Once the program is created, the test can be started. The cyclic load is applied until the specimen breaks. Once the test is finished, the specimen is extracted from the testing rig. The results are visualized on an SN curve. An SN curve has the fatigue damage criterion on the y-axis and the amount of cycles to failure on the x-axis. This graph helps us to better understand the fatigue damage process of friction stir welded joints by looking at properties like the slope and the data scatter. Ultimately, with the result of every friction stir welded joint in one graph, the aim is to reduce the amount of data scatter to a minimum. Having such a fatigue damage criterion allows to characterize and optimize the fatigue behavior of friction stir welded joints in steel structures, which is much better than that of conventional arc welded joints. This can be used to improve the performance of steel structures, including renewables like offshore floating wind turbines and solar platforms. To know more about the Resurgam project, follow us on social media and visit our website. This project is funded by the European Union.